In this video, you'll see how you can publish Amazon Machine Images, or AMIs, in AWS Marketplace. Why publish AMIs in AWS Marketplace? A technical validation report from Enterprise Strategy Group, or ESG, found that AWS Marketplace features contribute to improved procurement efficiency and increased compliance. When you publish your AMI to AWS Marketplace, you don't have to worry about cloning your AMI and hosting it in all the different AWS regions you want your AMI available in. Your AMI also deploys into the customer's own AWS account. We'll review the end-to-end publishing process, the AMI product types and their pricing models, how billing and integration works, how to submit AMI products and metadata, and how to review, test, and publish AMI products. We'll also discuss some common issues that might arise and how to avoid them. Let's begin with an overview of the end-to-end publishing process. As the seller of an AMI product, you'll prepare the AMI in your AWS seller account. You'll submit the AMI for scanning in the AWS Marketplace Management Portal. Next, you'll submit the product's metadata and pricing information. If you are using an AWS CloudFormation template for delivery, include the location of the template. AWS Marketplace then reviews your submitted materials and establishes a limited listing URL for your product. At this point, only authorized accounts can view and subscribe to the staged product. Next, you'll test the limited listing to ensure the subscribe and launch processes works how you expect. AWS Marketplace also tests your product for policy and security compliance, software vulnerabilities, and product usability. When both parties approve the limited listing, AWS Marketplace turns the product to live in coordination with your schedule. Next, let's review the AMI product types and pricing models. You can deliver your AMI-based product in one of three ways: as a single AMI with a CloudFormation template, or as a multi-AMI with CloudFormation template. The pricing models available for single AMIs and single AMIs with CloudFormation are the same. With hourly pricing, AWS Marketplace automatically tracks the buyer's hourly usage for each Amazon EC2 instance used. You can also offer buyers an upfront annual contract with a discount, a free trial, or a private offer. The monthly fixed pricing model charges buyers a monthly rate regardless of their usage. You can charge an additional hourly rate for EC2 instance usage, but you cannot extend private offers with this model. With a custom metering pricing model, you can define up to 24 dimensions on which to base costs. For example, you can define the number of product users or the amount of data put through the EC2 instance. You can also create private offers. With contract pricing, you can set a fixed upfront price for buyers' usage of dimensions within a specified contract period. Private offers can be made with this pricing model. The multi-AMI with CloudFormation product type supports only hourly pricing at this time, and private offers cannot be made. Next, we'll review how billing and integration work. The hourly and monthly pricing models don't require integration. Instead, when you submit your AMI to AWS Marketplace, a product code is attached that is used for automatic entitlement checks and billing. The code tells EC2 to check with AWS Marketplace to see if an account is subscribed before allowing the launch. If it is, Marketplace authorizes the launch and tracks the hours used by the EC2 instances. Note that if a buyer creates a copy of the AMI, the instances launched from that derivative AMI will also be tracked by Marketplace using the product code. To use the hourly or monthly pricing models, your AMI software must be fully functional out of the box and not require that buyers purchase additional licenses. The custom metering pricing model does require integration. Once a buyer launches an EC2 instance from your AMI, the software in your AMI sends an hourly meter usage API call that communicates the quantities consumed for dimensions being tracked for usage to the AWS Marketplace metering service, which then tabulates the cost. The contract pricing model also requires integration. After a contract is finalized, the buyer's upfront entitlements are stored with their AWS account in AWS License Manager. When the buyer launches an EC2 instance from your AMI, the software in your AMI makes a checkout license call to AWS License Manager for confirmation of entitlement before it becomes functional. Next, we'll look at how to submit a product and its metadata. Regardless of product type, you'll make a copy of the AMI and submit the image to AWS Marketplace. If your product includes CloudFormation templates, you'll submit them as well. Before you begin the submission process, your AMI should be ready in your AWS seller account in EC2 and stored in the US East 1 region so it can be accessed by AWS Marketplace. When ready to submit your AMI product, visit the AWS Marketplace Management Portal and add the AMI asset. Select your available AMIs from EC2 and move to the next step. AWS Marketplace requires permission to scan the AMI, so you'll supply an appropriate AWS Identity and Access Management, or IAM, role. Ensure the OS username and SSH port are accurate for your AMI. Then you'll wait as the scanning is performed. Once the scan is complete, you can move on. Next, you'll create a server product and identify which pricing model you will use. Based on your selection here, you'll be directed to one of two paths for supplying product information. You will fill out either an online form or an Excel sheet called a product load form, or PLF, and then load it back into the AWS Marketplace Management Portal. You'll use the online form of submitting a single AMI product that is free, charged hourly, or charged hourly with an annual upfront option. All others will require that you complete the PLF. If you're including a CloudFormation template with the product, you can provide the template URL on the PLF. If you're not hosting it publicly, AWS Marketplace will reach out to request the template after you've completed the submission. Finally, we'll go over the review, testing, and publishing steps. Once your limited testing is created, you'll have some back-and-forth communication with AWS Marketplace regarding its compliance and readiness. Here's what AWS Marketplace reviews. Your AMI can have no high or critical common vulnerabilities and exposures, or CVEs, no authorized keys or fixed default passwords, and must use key pair for SSH and not password authentication. Additionally, you must allow operating system level admin access. This means if you're using Linux, the root user must be accessible by the buyer. The product is reviewed for compliance with security requirements and AMI policies. Usage instructions must meet AWS Foundational Technical Review Guidelines, and any CloudFormation templates and diagrams must meet Marketplace best practices and requirements. Finally, AWS Marketplace will confirm the AMI product can successfully launch in accordance with the provided usage instructions and that it is accessible. There are some common issues sellers run into that you can anticipate and avoid when submitting your AMI product for publication or remedy. If high or critical CVEs are detected in the scan, you can review the results and patch the packages accordingly. Detection of authorized keys or OS passwords may prompt you to review AWS resources on best practices and guidelines for cleaning AMIs for sharing. Avoid using fixed default administrative passwords by setting a random password upon launch, such as the instance ID, which can be retrieved from the instance metadata service. If you find the PLF confusing, you can refer to seller guides on AWS Marketplace or contact the operations team with questions. The PLF is a temporary measure while the submission process is updated to become fully self-service. CloudFormation templates must be compliant with AWS Marketplace policies and best practices. Please ensure you review the guidelines for CloudFormation templates before submitting. After all resolutions are made and you've determined the product is good to publish, you can inform AWS Marketplace to make the product listing live. You've just seen how you can publish AMI products in AWS Marketplace. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.